The last application of Gauss law that we are going to see is electric field due to a spherical shell. So for a spherical shell, unlike the previous two cases, we will calculate at three points. One is inside the shell, one is on the surface, and the last one is outside the shell. So these are the three points where the electric field due to the system is going to get calculated. Okay. So I have seen one common mistake that gets that is made by all the students is thinking we have the word spherical, they assume that the charge is placed throughout the sphere. See, if you take a spherical shell, we know that shell is something which is hollow inside. So even if you try to charge that type of a material, remember, charge can exist only when there is a matter existing. When there are certain particles existing, then there will be some charge also existing. So if I take a spherical shell, if you try to charge this material, then what will happen is, due to its hollowness, all the charges that you give will only go and sit on the surface of the cylinder, sorry, surface of the sphere. Means all the charge will be distributed only on the outer part. So from this, make a clear note that there will be no charge that is existing within the spherical shell. The only place where the charge is existing is on the surface. Okay. Now, define the type of, we are going to apply Gauss law. The first step is define the type of charge density. So though sphere is a three-dimensional shape, here we cannot consider the volume charge density because the charge is not distributed over the volume, rather it is distributed on the surface area. Okay, as I told you, the charge is going to sit only on the surface, right? So since the charge is sitting only on the surface, the type of charge density we are going to define is sigma is equal to Q divided by A, where Q is going to be the total charge and the area here is going to be the, if I take the radius of the cylinder to be R, then the area that we are going to consider here is going to be 4 pi R square. This is the surface area of a sphere. Let this be point number 1. Now, consider Gaussian surface around the charge distribution. As I told you, unlike the previous cases, here we are going to calculate inside, on the surface and outside. So first, let's start with the case of inside. So in the case, when you consider it inside, let's say you are trying to calculate the electric field at point P, which is inside the sphere, spherical shell. Then the best Gaussian surface we can think of is another sphere. Okay, the only difference is going to be capital R represents the radius of the given object. Now we will consider a variable which is going to be smaller. Small r is going to change from place to place. So I am considering Gaussian surface of radius small r. So inside, if you try to apply the formula of Gauss law, so what does Gauss law state? Gauss law states the total flux is equal to the charge enclosed divided by epsilon naught. So in this case, if you observe, we need not solve it completely, because if you observe this diagram, there is no charge that is sitting within there is no charge that is sitting inside the spherical shell. So all the charge is distributed only on the surface. So what is the total charge that is enclosed by the Gaussian surface? This parameter is going to be a zero. Since the right hand side is zero, from this we can directly write stating that the electric field inside a spherical shell is a zero. So there is no electric field that is going to exist inside. If you want to write it for a one mark question, then the answer is going to be, since there is no charge that is present within the spherical shell, the electric field is zero. Okay, this value has to be remembered. Now similarly, we will consider a point outside. So for outside, I'll draw a separate diagram. Observe. So when you want to consider or calculate the value outside the spherical shell, so this distance is r, so this is r, okay. So let's take this distance as capital R, and the distance from the center to the point where the electric field is to be calculated as P. So the charge is going to get distributed on the surface, right? Again, when you follow the same steps, so we have completed the first two steps. The third step is consider a small area. So I will consider a small area on the Gaussian surface. Let me consider it here and assign the direction to it. Now, find the direction of electric field through the small area considered in step 3. If you observe, due to this charge, the electric field will be in the radially outward direction only because it's a positive charge. So, what exactly happens here is, so I'm considering due to this portion, the electric field at this point is going to be in the outward direction. So, E and dA, they both are in the same direction. So, the angle between them is 0 degrees. So, apply this formula. So, surface integral of E into dA into cos 0 degrees is going to give you the surface integral of E into dA into 1. So, let this be step number 2. Let this be second step. Now, find the total charge enclosed within the Gaussian surface. I have already told you the sum of all these charges put together is what is capital Q, right? So, the Gaussian, within the Gaussian surface, how much charge is there? The total charge that is there on the spherical shell. So, Q enclosed in this case will be equal to capital Q. So, let this be step number 3. Now, from 2 and 3, what we can do is the surface integral of E into dA is equal to the charge enclosed divided by epsilon naught. I am applying the Gauss law. Again, the electric field at that given point is going to be a constant. So, the value of electric field is taken out. E into the surface integral of dA is equal to, what is the charge enclosed? It is going to be Q divided by epsilon naught, the surface integral of dA. So, when you add all these dAs present on the Gaussian surface, since this is also a sphere, you will get the surface area of the spherical Gaussian surface that you have considered. So, E into, observe here, it will be 4 pi into small r square. This is where you need to be careful. 4 pi small r square is equal to Q divided by epsilon naught. So, from this what we can conclude is E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. So, this result is similar to the result which you obtain when you have a point charge, and from the point charge, if you know the distance, this is going to be the magnitude of the electric field that we will obtain. So, what we can conclude from here is, though the spherical shell is having all the charges distributed on the surface, for calculating the electric field outside, this total charge can be considered as a point charge which is exactly concentrated at its center. Okay, so this is for the point outside. Now, we will try to calculate for the point on the surface. You will calculate on the surface. So, this is a very simple case. Since outside, what is the electric field? E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught small r square. For surface, what we can do is small r is equal to capital R. If you substitute the value here, then E will be equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught capital R square. So, there are three values of electric field that we have obtained. So, if I write it in the mathematical form, E is equal to 0 if the value of R is strictly less than capital R. Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught small r square, sorry, capital R square, if R is equal to capital R, it will be Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught small r square for R value greater than capital R. Now, keeping all these factors in mind, if you try to plot the graph for this particular function, E is going to be a function of R. So, E is a function of R. When you write it like this, when you plot the graph will be like this. Observe. From the center till the circumference. So, this is small r is equal to capital R. Till this point, what happens is the electric field value is a 0. So, observe, the electric field is going to be 0. At R is equal to capital R, the value becomes maximum. This is at R is equal to R. It suddenly gets raised. After that, again it starts decreasing as the value of R is increasing. So, this is how the graph will be. So this value is q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught small r square. This value of electric field is q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught capital R square, and here it is 0. So this is all about a spherical.